And here at 2K Sports, we couldn't be happier. Joined in the booth with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan. A contest in the West. We'll see if the Dallas Mavericks can please their home crowd. And going against New Orleans, their first game of the NBA's regular season. Last season, they had the upper hand in the series, going 3-1 against these guys.
And they were able to take the season series in that matchup last year. But overall, two teams that were very similar in the standings.
Yeah, they were able to make the plays to come out on top, but it really could have gone either way. And you could say the same for tonight's game.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So for New Orleans right now, Pondexter and Davis fill up the forward slots. Holiday and Evans comprise the backcourt. And it's Ajinsa in at the center position.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
Nowitzki's shot is no good.
A clear look at the hoop. He doesn't miss many of those.
Outside Holiday. A three ball. A shot no good. And it's Dallas the other way. Always seems the Mavs are able to compete for a title, Clark, but their window might be closing with some of their stars aging, namely Dirk Nowitzki.
You're exactly right, Kevin, because Dirk is the centerpiece of that franchise, has been for over a decade. They made the Rondo trade last year trying for a big finals run, but eventually they'll start to have to build for the future.
And good defense there to play up and get a hand in the face.
Well, he's got a tough mindset. He's confident as a defender. And when you combine those two things, it makes it real hard to score on him.
Williams dishes to Villanueva. That's tipped. Kicks it out to Parsons. Dallas, no good that time either. Looking at Dallas, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Bulls.
Take a look at last year's Dallas Mavericks and where they ranked in the NBA. Second in points off turnovers, third in scoring, and they also showed up in the top five in fewest turnovers. When you squeeze the orange and take care of the basketball like they do, you put yourself in position to win.
And go back to points off those turnovers. I mean, teams really get caught unprepared to deal with that blitzing style, that trapping, diving in the passing lanes, and then running it down your throat in transition.
Evans kicks to Ajinsa. Yes, and a nice assist from Evans.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
Williams passes to Nowitzki. Holiday against Williams. Back to Nowitzki. A shot. That's short off the rim.
Ill-advised shot there, Clark.
Yeah, exactly. That was lower than low percentage.
Pondexter with it. Matthews covering. Goes up with it. It's deflected. Holiday against Williams. Parsons on the wing. Shot clock at six. There's the triple. No good. Davis with some nice D.
Oh, that's a tough three-point try when you've got the defense right there.
Well, he'd have to be really good to knock down the shot like that against that kind of defense.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
Here's Williams. The Pelicans make their last shot. Parsons on the wing. Down low. Out of bounds, New Orleans will take possession.
You always want a player to have his head up and to be surveying the court, but not if that's going to be the result.
Looking at Dallas, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Bulls in Chicago. Holiday with the three. The Mavericks trailing. And Parsons kicks to Nowitzki. Ajinsa dishes to Pondexter. Here's Holiday. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Yeah, the defender all over us.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
Pelicans shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one. Last year, the Pelicans, Greg, pushed their way into the postseason. It was a neck-and-neck battle for that number eight spot, as you recall, with the Oklahoma City Thunder.
And how about the excitement down the stretch? They were able to edge out the Thunder and Russell Westbrook on that just point binge down the stretch there. And what a final day that was. A big, huge win over the Spurs let them get into the postseason for the first time under the Pelican moniker. And it doesn't really matter who starts a break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes it.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
And he gets it to go.
They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Clearly, they've been the aggressor.
And so the first quarter is in the books. Pelicans ahead, up five. And we'll get going after this from the American Airlines Center. And now the second quarter, just getting set to start. And looking at what we've seen from the Pelicans, what do you guys think?
I just don't know that you're going to see a better quarter defensively than what we saw in the first.
Really a big part of why they're on top here. The defense has been on point.
Parsons and Dirk are in at the forward spots. Matthews out there with Williams. And it's Villanueva in at the five spot. So that's who Dallas starts the second with. Outside Williams. And it's Villanueva at the elbow. Unloads from 13. Matthews passes to Williams. That one's good. Maybe that'll get him going after a 2-for-6 start.
That's a shot he shouldn't be afraid to take more often.
Holiday goes in. Some solid D from Nowitzki.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
And Parsons kicks to Matthews. Out of bounds. Dallas takes possession. And we've played through the first minute here in the second. Williams dishes to Villanueva. It's rebounded by New Orleans.
Major defensive lapse right there. I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You've got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
And here's Matthews from the arc. They get it back. And that is good. And that's now 7 points for Nowitzki.
How about the purpose with which he's crashing the backboards right now? Some hard-earned second-chance points.
Anderson passes to Holiday. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That's on Darren Williams. Well, last year, the Pelicans were team on the rise, making the playoffs, a solid season overall, especially on the road. Really, they sent notice by what they did away from New Orleans.
Yeah, I mean, 17 road wins. I mean, you say to yourself, well, that doesn't sound great. But when you're a young, up-and-coming team, one of the things that you can really value is your ability to go into hostile environments and have success. They're going to be building on that confidence.
And Dallas calls their first time out of the game.
As for the Pelicans on the road, I mean, they had the fewest road wins of all the West playoff teams. The franchise hasn't had a winning road record since 2009 when they were the Hornets.
And he can't hit the second.
And for the Pelicans and their road struggles last season, they are a younger team. It's a team built around a young superstar in Anthony Davis. So taking road lumps is just kind of part of that growing process.
And Holiday kicks to Evans. Matthews with a steal. It's tipped. The dish to Nowitzki. Stolen by Holiday. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Well, let's take a look at where New Orleans ended up rank-wise in the league last year, Kevin. First in blocks. Fourth in three-point field goal percentage. And they were top 10 in fewest team turnovers. This team has a number of players that take care of the ball and value every possession.
And that block shot ranking, really something to highlight. Their ability to contest and deny shots around the rim was a tremendous asset defensively.
Another trip to the stripe for him, and I tell you what, a little bit of a different feel here in the second quarter. A little more banging going on.
Man, and it's really served them well, seeking out the contact you mentioned and putting pressure on the defense.
And Matthews kicks to Parsons. And Davis sends it back. And it's sent back by Nowitzki. Parsons attacking. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Parsons. And now we've got the intentional foul.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for that kind of foul. I mean, that might be an explanation for it, but certainly doesn't justify it. And even then, it's just not a good play.
Dallas calls timeout.
Yeah, just frustrated by their lack of production offensively, and I can't blame them. I mean, they're getting the looks, but the shots just aren't falling.
Yeah, and the slump that they're having shooting the ball can take its toll on you if you're not mentally strong. So I like this timeout here to try to get those guys reset and refocused.
Some changes here for the Mavericks. Pachulia comes in for Charlie Villanueva. And Devin Harris is subbed in for Williams. Eric Gordon, he's checked in for New Orleans. Offensive rebound.
Well, he's building a house with those bricks. I mean, one reason is he keeps trying to force it up when he's defended well. Move the ball, share the sugar. He is an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
You know, he picks the simple one-handed stuff to get the 2 points.
Yeah, and in a close game, though, guys, those could be really important points.
Right back to the basics there, using the one-hand slam for that one.
Doesn't he make the basics look pretty exceptional?
Yeah, he does. They look sweet when he does them.
And he better stay with those basics because this game is still yet to be determined.
Here's Nowitzki. He's got 9. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And it's Harris off the drive. Here's Pachulia. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Pachulia's got his first basket.
Bad matchup for the defense, no doubt about it. Doesn't have the height to influence the shot there. Never mind blocking.
It's stolen by Harris. And here comes Parsons leading the fast break. Matthews dishes to Nowitzki. The Mavericks shooting their first free throws of the game. And that one falls for Parsons.
You know, you look at Dallas, and that team didn't rely too much on the mid-range or the short game last season, but they could have. They shot 70% from 12 feet and in, excluding drives. That's pretty good.
And Holiday, here we go. And the jam by Ajinsa.
Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Hey, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
Dallas might always be considered a football town, but they take their basketball seriously here, too. Huge attendance numbers. A long string of games for consecutive sellouts for the Mavs, not only last season, but for many years gone by.
And how about being third in the league in average attendance? And by percentages, they were first as they oversold the capacity of their stadium on average.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says, but still anybody's game.
Nice silky finish on the alley-oop.
That sequence, I don't think Clark could have been executed any better.
Stupendous feat.
And that's the beauty of the game right there. I hope we get the opportunity to see a few more of those.
Nowitzki outside. From deep. Basket is good. The assist from Harris. And it's a 5-point Maverick lead. Outside Holiday. And no good trying to get that one. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of basketball. It's down. Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half. Dirk Nowitzki having a dominant impact in this game.
Yeah, the effort and intensity from a defensive standpoint has just really been superb, really firing up his team.
Guys, I love his activity, patrolling the court, blocking shot after shot out there. He's really made a statement at the defensive end.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. Dirk Nowitzki having a dominant impact in this game.
And he just went off in those first two quarters, guys. He's capable of doing that on a consistent basis as well. So we might see some changes from a defensive standpoint as they try to disrupt his rhythm in the second half.
You know, guys, I think you've got to make some sort of change. I mean, they can't let him continue to torch him up like he has been.
So for New Orleans right now, Pondexter and Davis fill up the forward slots. Holiday and Evans comprise the backcourt. And it's Perkins in at the center. The Mavericks shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. And Pachulia drops them both.
You know, as the season wore on, guys, the Pelicans became a matchup that nobody wanted to see. Very tough against teams and had very few weaknesses, too.
Yeah, starting the second half nicely there. Love those easy lay-ins to get things going.
And it's Harris off the drive. Offensive rebound. Nowitzki, the pass to Harris. And Matthews kicks to Pachulia. Back to Matthews. Another shot. Out to Harris. And finally they hit one. Harris is got the lead up to five now for the Mavs.
Probably wasn't the shot they were looking for, but they'll take the bucket.
Well, for the Pelicans last season, they were a tough matchup. The defense was one thing, but their mentality, the way they fought through the game, was fantastic.
Yeah, and Kevin, you look at their record against other playoff teams, and it stacks up well. I mean, they made the playoffs by never thinking they were at a disadvantage on the floor, and having that kind of confidence in a young team, that only really speaks for positives moving forward.
Big change last year for the Mavs came when they traded for Rajon Rondo. It looked to be the missing piece for him, Clark, but boy, it just never seemed to come together.
You just don't know. Trades are always risky. You don't know how they're going to work out. And I give credit to ownership for talking to the players to see what they thought about the trade before they actually made the deal.
Davis kicks to Evans. But they get it back. And finished off by Davis.
He is one guy you do not stand in the way of when he decides to attack the rim.
Mavericks leading by five.
And things just didn't really work out with Rondo here with the Mavs. Missed a lot of games and at times clashed with that coaching staff.
And it's Harris off the drive. Back to Nowitzki. Second shot opportunity. They shoot again. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. This is his first trip to the line tonight. And that one falls for Nowitzki.
And, you know, they said it was the injury, but
You have to suspect the Mavs just shut him down in the playoffs. They took a big swing and missed with Rondo in acquiring him, but I think you have to give them credit for at least taking the risk.
Out of bounds, Dallas takes possession.